Here is my start file. You can download the exercise file and follow along by clicking on the link below this video. In this tutorial, we explore the interface of Access. Microsoft Access is a relational database management application, and essentially it performs three things. It stores the raw data, it organizes this data, and enables us to extract information. An Access database consists of a building block, and the building block of an Access database is a group of tables. This is where we store information. An Access database consists of multiple objects or multiple elements. So, although the main building block is tables, but we do have some other database objects like the forms that feed the table, the queries to extract information from the tables, and the report to display this information. I want to start by exploring the navigation pane to the left side of the Access window. And the navigation pane showed the different Access objects, but you can filter the different Access objects by clicking to the right side of the navigation pane where you see all Access objects. If you click on the down pointing arrow, you can focus on one specific object, let's say tables. So if I select tables, I just see tables. If I click another time and select queries, I have a single query in this database. I can focus on forms, so I see that this database includes one single form, and I can go back to all Access objects by selecting the last option in the drop list, all Access objects. Opening a database object can be done either by double clicking, so I can open, let's say, table order. This table stores the different order of this business. I can open another table on top of it by right-clicking this time and select Open, and it opens in a second tab. A table consists of vertical structures called fields, like the city field, the region field, and it consists of horizontal structures called records, and the intersection of a field and a record is called a value. In a table, the leftmost field is a unique identifier. It does not have duplicates, and it uniquely identifies each record, and we call it the primary key. The primary key is extremely important in an Access database because we use it to connect the different tables together. Because the tables in Access are not flat tables like the tables in Excel. They are related to each other, and to create these relationships, we need the primary key of each table because creating a relationship will be a matter of dragging and dropping. We drag the primary key of one table and we drop it over a matching field in another table. Whatever you want to do in a table can be done in a form. Let me open the form, form retailer, that is related to this table. So in the navigation pane, if I double click on form retailer, now it opens the form, and you can see that in a form, I see one single record at a time. A form is a user-friendly structure, and it enables us to navigate the different records by clicking on the navigation buttons to the bottom here, or I can add a record, or I can delete a record, or modify a record. This is the first record, so what if I modify it by typing a different name? I'm going to type my name. And I'll be typing my last name, and then close the form. Note that when I close the form, no one will ask me for saving, because everything is saved automatically in a database. All the value changes that you do are saved automatically. And you might think it didn't save, but because here is the table that is related to the previous form, then you will see that the change that I have done in the form has been communicated to the first record of the table. Now I can change it back here in the same table, so I'll be typing Carol Murray, and this change does not require saving, so if I want to save my table, no one will ask me to save. However, if I open the same table one more time and I make a minor change to the design, I will be required to save. A minor change could be as simple as expanding a column for 1 millimeter. Now that I expanded the city column, if I try to close the table, then Access will tell me, well, you made a change to the design. You need to save it. So I click on Yes. A table has multiple views in Access. So I can open the table in Datasheet view, and that's the default view. But I can switch to the design view. Datasheet view is used for entering data, while the design view is used by the developer to create the structure of the database. To switch between views, you can go either to the upper left side of the Home tab. We have a View command. So if you click on this command, it's a toggle button. It takes me to the design view. And if I click one more time, it takes me back to the datasheet view. I can also switch views from the lower right corner. So I have two icons, one for switching to the design view and the other one for switching to the datasheet view. Let's look at the names in datasheet view, these simple names, these user-friendly names, and let's compare them to what we see in design view. As I said, either upper left or lower right. I'm going to switch to design view. In design view, the table is divided into two parts, an upper section and a lower section called the properties. In the upper section, I see three columns. The leftmost column is called the field name. The middle one is for the data type, and the rightmost is an optional column to add a description to guide the user what we expect in each specific field. If you look at the description, where do we see it when we switch to datasheet view? Let's look at the first one, the retailer ID. So if I switch to datasheet view one more time, what we saw in the description of the first field, if I select any value for the first field, then I see it to the left side of the status bar. This is the description column. Let's switch back to design view. I click on the upper left, and I'm switching back to design view, and I would like to have a closer look to each one of the columns. First of all, I have the field name column, and you might have noticed that the field names in design view are a little bit more complicated than what we see in datasheet view. And each name has a user-friendly version in the properties. So if you look at the properties, you will see a simplified version of the name. This is the user-friendly version. You can type whatever you want for the caption or the user-friendly version of the name. While for the developer name or the designer version of the name, it has a universal convention and it follows this convention. So let's understand how we name these fields, but before we need to explore the data type because it's tightly related to naming. If you select any cell under data type and you click on the down pointing arrow, you see the different data types. So I have short text, long text, number, large number, date and time, currency, auto number, and so on. The auto number means that whenever you assign this to the ID field and you add more records, it will increment automatically. And that's why you don't have any duplicates. So it makes data entry a lot easier and you don't have to worry about the incrementation of the number. For the short text, I use it for something like a first name, a last name, a retailer name. We have other data types as well, and each one of these data types is used in a different situation, as we'll see when we create tables. But let's talk about the universal convention of naming fields, and this one is called the Hungarian notation. In the Hungarian notation, you have four rules. Number one, you have to use a descriptive name. Number two, omit the space. Number three, capitalize the first letter of each word. This is what we call a camel case. And number four, you have to add the abbreviated data type before the field name, and you add it in lowercase. So when I say str retailer name, that simply means it's a text. Str stands for string of text. And automatically, when you make a change, you see that the properties in the lower section change because these properties are related to the data type.